Hello children, so we meet again for the last class of the topic prepositions. Today I'll explain you about some more of the prepositions and at the end of the session we will have some practice exercises. So children, please keep a copy and pen ready. Children, in the class we had done till the preposition of, OFF of. Today we'll start with the uses of the preposition by. By refers to the doer or the agent, that is by whom the work is being performed. Let's take for example, my clothes are being washed by my mother. He was stabbed by his enemy. In these two examples, by is actually employing by whom the work is being done. The next use of by is to tell the time or in the sense according to. For example, it is 4 by my watch. Thirdly, it shows the manner of an action, that is how an action is being done. He caught me by the collar. The next use of by is, it denotes nearness of time when an action is to be finished. For example, he will have come home by the evening. The farmer will have plowed the fields by dusk. The next preposition is with. With refers to the instrument, that is the thing with which the work is being done. For example, the letter was written by me with a pen. He was stabbed by his enemy with a dagger. It also denotes company. I went to Delhi with my uncle. He works with me. Next preposition is till and by. Here we will actually differentiate how and where to use till and how and where to use by. Till means up to a particular thing or up to a particular time, whereas by means not later than, मतलब उस चीज के बाद का नहीं, और till का मतलब वहां तक सीमित. Let's take for example, I shall wait for you till 7 p.m. I shall come back by 10 p.m. Now in example 1, that means कि मैं तुम्हारे लिए 7 बजे तक वेट करूंगा, और दूसरे example में उसका मतलब कि मैं उस time तक आ जाऊंगा, उससे ज्यादा देर नहीं करूंगा. Children, please note one more thing here. By also is used for the means of conveyance. That means when we use for things like transportation from one place to the other, then also we use by. For example, I went to Jaipur by car. Children, the next preposition is to. To is used to denote motion from one place to another. For example, he walked to the end of the road. He goes to school every day at 7 o'clock. Children, to is also used to denote time and limit. For example, it is 4:15 now. It is 5 minutes to 10. Thirdly, it is used with senior, junior, inferior, superior, etc. For example, he is superior to me. Ram is junior to me. Lastly, it is also used to express some feelings. For example, he is most helpful to the poor. He has great regard to his seniors. The last prepositions are over, above, under and below. Over is used in the sense of beyond. For example, the sun is shining over my head. The sky is over our heads. Over is actually the opposite of under. Therefore, over implies the relation of highest in position, and under shows lower position. For example, the cattle are grazing under a tree. We rested under a bridge. उसके नीचे means उसके position से नीचे गलत हो गया.
यार क्या कर.
To also is used to denote time and limit. For example, it is 4:45 now. It is 5:50. Next, it is also used with words like senior, junior, inferior, etc. For example, he is superior to me, Ram is junior to me. Lastly, to also is used to express some feelings. Let's take for example, he is most helpful to the poor. He has great regard to his seniors. The last prepositions are over, above, under and below. Over is basically used in the sense of beyond, upar, you could say. The sun is shining over my head, the sky is over our heads. Over is actually the opposite of under. Therefore, over implies the relation of highest in position and under shows lower position. Higher means upar and lower means niche. The cattle are grazing under a tree. We rested under a bridge. Similarly, above is used to express higher than or more than, etc. Above is the opposite of below. Therefore, above shows higher in position and below shows lower in position. Above also shows rest in a higher position, while below shows the rest in lower position. For example, his head is above water. He is below me in the class. Children, we end our session with of prepositions here. Children, with this we end our today's class. And now I'll be giving you some practice exercises which will be based on the topic prepositions only. Students, you need to do these exercises in your notebooks. Children, these are the assignments which you need to do in your copies. Please note down the sentences in your copies. Children, this is the second practice exercise which you need to do in your notebooks. With this, we end our topic prepositions and we'll meet again in the next session with a new topic. Thank you.